Greetings, YouTube. Today we're going to get our feet wet in some organic chemistry. We're going to synthesize 2-bromopropane from 2-propanol, also known as isopropyl alcohol, or rubbing alcohol. So to begin, you're going to need a boiling flask. I'm using a 250-milliliter round bottom flask. Next, you will need 180 milliliters of hydrobromic acid that we made from a previous video. And last, you will need 50 milliliters of isopropyl alcohol. I'm using some 99.9% I bought from an electronics store to clean electronic parts. You can use 91% that you can buy from any pharmacy. I chose to use isopropyl alcohol in this reaction because it is so easy to obtain, and more importantly, we can get one product instead of a mixture. So, pour the isopropyl alcohol into your flask, being careful not to pour any out. And then add your hydrobromic acid. Isopropyl alcohol is a secondary alcohol, so adding this acid to this alcohol right now won't cause any reaction to occur. If this was tert butyl alcohol, we could get a reaction immediately without even having to heat it up. Okay, so we have our mixture, so now it's time to go and set up for a simple distillation. Okay, so here's my setup. I have a Variac to power my heating mantle right here, which of course heats the solution we just made, and to run it through our distillation setup here with a condensing column and a receiving flask. And don't forget your thermometer, because you're going to need to know the temperature. Okay, while we wait for it to start to boil, let's take a look at the mechanism for this reaction and get an idea of what is going on. So, isopropyl alcohol is just propane with an OH function group on the secondary carbon. We're going to dehydrate this molecule, which means we're going to remove that OH group. So to begin, we notice that this oxygen atom has 2 lone pairs of electrons. One of those lone pairs is going to attack the hydrobromic acid molecule and remove a hydrogen atom to form a negative bromine anion. This converts the OH group, which is a terrible leaving group, to a positively charged H2O group, which is a great leaving group. Given time, the water will detach from the molecule, taking its electrons with it, and leaving what is called a positively charged carbocation intermediate. This intermediate is impossible to isolate because it is so fleeting. It is fleeting because the negatively charged bromine ion will immediately attack it, forming our major product. Now, this is called an SN1 reaction. And I'm sorry I don't have time to fully explain SN1 reactions, other than to say that an SN1 reaction always happens with an E1 reaction. And our E1 product will be the minor product propene, which is a gas, so any form will float away and not contaminate our major product. Okay. So our mixture is at a nice boil, and checking the thermometer, I can see that the temperature is right at 62 degrees, which is very close to the 60 degrees 2-bromopropane boils at. And looking at our receiving flask, you can see that we're collecting product. In total, I let this distill for about 2.5 hours. However, once the drops slow way down and the temperature starts to move up, it's done. So now we have our product, and it's time to remove any water and alcohol that may still be in it. So make a solution of sodium chloride, a saturated solution, and you'll also need a SEP funnel to separate the two solutions. And here's our product. Okay, so pull the stopper out of the SEP funnel and make sure that the valve is closed. and pour your product in. A little hasty there. Alright, so now we want to add in about 20 milliliters of our saturated sodium chloride solution. What we're doing now is removing most of the water and alcohol. Okay, vent it and begin the shake. This will help so that later on we don't have to use so much expensive drying agent, because the sodium chloride solution will get most of the water and alcohol out. Okay, so when we're done, you'll see two layers form. The bottom layer is the water and salt layer, and the top layer is our product. This is the first indication, really, that we actually have a product. 2-bromopropane is not soluble in water or ethanol, so the fact that they're not mixing is a good indication that we actually have a product. So we want to remove the bottom layer and discard it. So take the stopper off the top and push your valve until you start letting some of the water through. Once you get down to the very bottom, you'll want to take a real close look and make sure to be careful not to drain off any of your product on the top layer. Okay, I'm going to do this elsewhere. Okay, now we want to get the solution as dry as possible. So pour your solution into a small beaker like the one I have here. And then we want to add in our magnetic stir bar. And then go ahead and start it stirring at a very low speed. And now we're going to add in a couple scoops of anhydrous magnesium sulfate, aka Epsom salt. To make anhydrous magnesium sulfate, you'll just need to heat some in your oven at around 500, or as hot as it'll go, and broil, I guess. So that will remove the water, making it anhydrous. I'm using magnesium sulfate in this particular example just because it's easy to get, where other drying agents aren't as easy. You'd have to order them online. Okay, so we're going to start up a stir. And you'll want to let this stir 20 to 30 minutes for the drying agent to really work. Keep a close eye on it, and you'll also want to put maybe a watch glass like this one on top to keep any splatters from occurring. Okay, so I won't make you wait for the whole time, and we'll skip ahead. So here's the solution after we're done. I've pulled the magnetic stir bar out, and I've grabbed a small container to put the product in. Now the magnesium sulfate is still in there, so we're going to decant off our 2-bromopropane into this small vial, being careful not to pour any of the magnesium sulfate. Now, I said earlier that 2-bromopropane, we were sure that we had a product because it's separated into two different layers. Another good indication that you created something different that you're not messing just alcohol, is it the smell? Two-bromopropane has a much different smell than an alcohol. You would never confuse one for the other. It doesn't really smell bad. It just has kind of an, I don't know, a slightly acrid smell, I'd assume. The other thing to notice and remember about this particular substance is that it is a halogenated hydrocarbon, so they do tend to be carcinogenic. So be careful about breathing this substance or spending a lot of time with it, because it does have the potential of maybe being dangerous. Okay, screw it on real tight. You'll want to store this in a cool place, because it does have a pretty low boiling point and a really high vapor pressure. And here we go. So, thanks for watching. Please rate, comment, and if you like these videos, please subscribe.